Revelio.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Revelio.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
Everybody grab a broom, and we shall get started. Mr. Clopton, your attention, please.
Sorry, Madam Kagawa.
Everyone, please welcome a new student to our flying class.
Welcome.
The goal of today is to remind all of you how to maneuver on a broomstick safely. As broom flight is, first and foremost, a means of transportation.
This, I fear, some of you have forgotten.
Diving, rolling, and loop-the-loops will not be taught or in fact tolerated in this class. We'll leave that to professional Quidditch players, like the Toyohashi Tengu. Not a fan, I take it? Now, let's see how well everyone kept up with their practice over the summer holidays. For those who need a refresher, step up to your broom. Say up firmly and clearly. Then kick your leg over and rest your weight on the seat. Up!
Thank you.
Now, your turn. Up.
Up, you stupid ratty school broom!
Up.
One leg over, so there's a leg on each side. None of that side saddle nonsense. A gust of wind will throw you right off. And if you hear my whistle while you're in flight, ground yourself at once. Good. Now, for your first lesson, fly through each ring in the courtyard. Do take care.
Wish
the brooms are school property. I want them returned in one piece.
This is brilliant.
Well done. Now that you're acclimatized to your broom, let's see how well you manage with a more advanced exercise, shall we? This next set of rings will take you around the grounds for more of a challenge.
What a view!
Hello! Nice day for a flight!
This is rather fun.
Oh, the old boathouse. Wish you could have experienced crossing the lake as a first year. Whoa! Our aquatic resident likes to make an appearance once in a while.
Ha! Good. I've got this.
I say, I watched you fly through those rings. You seem to handle yourself on that dusty school broom well enough. I'd imagine you're ready for something a bit more challenging. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We haven't properly met. I'm Everett Clopton. Am I right in suspecting that a Hufflepuff like you might be interested in some high-flying fun?
Can't say no to that. What did you have in mind?
A bit of a detour, so to speak. Follow me. The tour is about to begin. Follow closely now. Right now, we're flying over the Transfiguration Courtyard. Lovely as ever. Let's hope the headmaster isn't having tea by the window today. Nice to get above it all, isn't it? Ahead are the gardens. The Hufflepuff common room windows just peek out. Bit claustrophobic for my taste.
How is Everett flying so quickly?
Here's something handy to know. Lean forward for a burst of speed. Helpful if you need to escape a tricky situation.
Now that's more like it.
You sure you're not part hippogriff?
There's the famous bridge. Think of all the magic holding it up. I mean, look at it. And the owlery. That's a bit of solid architecture, isn't it?
Flying tips and a jaunt around Hogwarts. This is quite the tour, Everett.
Have you two been?
Oh, hello, Professor. We were trying to get a bit of extra practice in.
Hefty points will be taken from each of you for not following my instructions. Mr. Clopton, I am disappointed in you. You're in this class because you're still not showing yourself, or frankly, your broom, the proper respect.
But, Professor...
Enough! Class is finished for the day. As for you, you do well to use better judgment in the future. Chin up. That was some rather good flying.
Sorry about that business with Kagawa, but you have to admit, those views were worth it.
It was worth losing a few house points for that detour.
You seem at home on a broom. Bet if you had a fancy mop.
But I rather enjoy the company.
Thank you. I've not forgotten about our library venture. How did you fare? If you're keen for some illicit spell practice...
Rebellion.
It's against the Dark Arts classroom. I know a discreet place near there.
Ah, new face. Wonderful.
Good day to you. I require assistance with a delivery and thought you might be interested. Please visit me at J. Pippin's Potions if you'd like to earn a few coins.
Hello. Mr. Weeks, is it?
Albie Weeks at your service. Welcome to Spintwitches. Apologies if you came by before and weren't able to come in. Shop's been closed since trade routes were disrupted. Had to travel as far as London to meet with my supplier. And I've only just returned, thankfully, with inventory. I presume you're in the market for a new broom? Got a few rare yew weavers available. Ember Dash, Silver Arrows. Wind Wisps, too. No matter what broom you choose, you'll be pleased. They're all exceptional, both in quality and performance.
You said disrupted trade routes caused you to close, Spintwitches.
Terrible it's been. Trade routes reported as unusable. Evidently criminals were overtaking roads, threatening hamlets. I can fly safely almost anywhere, but you try flying with an inventory of brooms on your back. No easy feat. Right then, back to work. If a particular broom takes your fancy, just let me know.
Sounds quite the array of brooms. I'll have a look around. Thank you.
Nice doing business with you. That item is of the highest quality. That item is of the highest quality. You'll be thrilled with that broom, I promise you. Whilst nearly any broom will certainly be a step up from the practice brooms in Kagawa's class, they all have their limitations. You seem to be a flyer who might be interested in, say, some enhancements?
Go on.
Ha! Knew I was right about you. I think you'll be quite happy with the performance of any broom at lower altitudes. But you may notice that speed consistency tends to falter as you rise. I believe I can remedy this issue. I have some ideas for enchantments, upgrades, if you will, that will improve the performance of any broom you fly. What I need is someone to conduct a broom flight and report back to me so I can perfect the upgrades. As it happens, another Hogwarts student, Imelda Reyes, is using abandoned broom courses for time trials. Clever girl. An ideal situation for collecting flight statistics. If you were to compete for the best time and succeed, then report back to me with how your broom behaved, I could complete work on my first upgrade. What say?
That sounds intriguing. I'll see what I can do.
Thank you. It'll be worth your while. If I'm right, the new upgrade ought to enhance brooms in every regard. And I can give you a special price. The time trial should be a bit of fun too. Go to the Quidditch pitch and Imelda Reyes will sort you out. Once you've beaten Imelda's time, be sure to let me know.
Rebellion.
Can't help but admire Mr. Weeks' enthusiasm. Lumos. Rebellion. Lumos.
Hello there. In the market for potions, are we? Wise decision. Thank you. I hope to see you again. Farewell for now.
Rebellion. Hello, Mr. Pippin. You need help with a delivery?
Yes, I do. A capable student such as yourself should have no trouble making the trip to Cambridge. It's just south of Hogwarts.
What do you need delivered?
Fatima Lawang ordered a few invisibility potions. I used to go myself, but lately Fatima has taken to turning every visit into an argument. Constantly complaining about the quality of my stock. But how can I maintain excellence when she orders so often, giving me no time to brew? If you take this rather irritating task off my hands, I'd happily allow you to claim the delivery fee from Fatima.
I'd be happy to help with the delivery.
You've no idea how grateful I am, truly. Here are the invisibility potions she requested. Hopefully she won't give you too much trouble. She's a talented potioner in her own right. I dare say I wouldn't mind having a look at her potion recipes one day.
center.
Let's see what's up your sleeve this time, Merlin.
Rebellion. Incendio. Incendio. Rebellion.
Look.
Lumos. Repair. Incendio.
Keen on Keenbridge. Hang on to your valuables. That's all I'll say.
Rebellion.
Yeah.
Let me open. Revelio. Revelio.
The kitchen could have been here by now.
Leviosa.
That Pippin should have been here by now. That Pippin should have been here by now. Always late, that Pippin.
Revelio. 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 Revelio.
Pippin should have been here by now.
Revelio.
Madam Luang, I have a delivery from J. Pippin's potions.
Ha! Sent a child to do his work for him, did he? Always cutting corners and taking the easy way out. Did he have you brew them for him as well? Doesn't matter. You could probably do it better than he can anyway.
Here are the potions you requested.
You think it's so simple? I know Pippin is always trying to cheat his customers. Cutting corners to save some galleons for himself at the expense of quality. You'll not be getting a canut out of me until you prove the potion works. Drink it.
Seems simple enough. I'll do it.
I should think so.
It seems to have worked.
Well, I suppose that will do.
If the demand for potions is as high as you say, have you considered being easier to work with? Perhaps combining your recipes and skills?
Ha! Not a chance. That ne'er-do-well had his shop handed to him. The rest of us had to make our own way. I'll not give him the benefit of my hard work and gumption. If he fails on his own, so be it.
Very well. I shall let Mr. Pippin know I delivered the potions as requested.
You do that.
What do you have for sale?
A fine choice. Exactly what I would have chosen. This will do just fine. Thank you. Thank you for stopping in. I appreciate it.
Let me in, sir. Revelio. Revelio. This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
Rebellion.
Lead to something grand.
You'll enjoy your time in Irondale.
I know what that means. Merlin trial.
Rebellion.
Fascinating.
Looks rather dark in there. Never stopped me before.
Rebellion.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Revelio.
Oh, how I love a good puzzle.
Rebellion.
Who lived here, I wonder?
Rebellion! Leviosa! Accio! Leviosa! Accio! Incendio! Rebellion!
Could it be?
Revelio.
Instantly. Revelio. Revelio.
Great spider. Incendi. Revelio. Incendio. In
send
you.
Shun that which leads it astray.
I won't rest.
Let me
have Nora Treadwell's precious gun. Else to be toyed.
You are postponing the inevitable!
Stop flitting around like a billywig!
Stop it!
Let me go!
It isn't Nora Treadwell Guardian.
I've robbed every traveling.
Perhaps
I'll make you wish you were back in school.
How embarrassing!
Incendio.
That's mine.
No one to share in my victory. Tell him what lies in wait for me in there.
Revelio.
Greetings. Please, take your time looking about. Now, you let me know if there's anything else I can help you with. You've a good head for business, haven't you? No one can say I don't keep a stacked shelf.
We have everything a young student might need when it comes to potions. Have a good look around. I hope to see you again. Farewell for now. I hope to see you again. Farewell for now.
I delivered the potions to Fatima Luang.
Very good. And did she cause you any trouble?
I can see why you didn't want to go. She was quite cantankerous.
I do truly appreciate your help. And at least it's done with.
It was a pleasure doing business with you, Mr. Pippin.
Likewise. Worth every bit of that delivery fee to have someone capable deal with that witch.
By the way, I found this book of potion recipes in Keenbridge. Might it be useful to you?
Is this Fatima's recipe book?
Oh, I had no idea it was hers.
Some things are sacred amongst potioneers. I shall return it to her immediately.
What do you have in store for me this time?
Rebellion! Rebellion!
These Merlin trials won't get the best of me.
Imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented.
Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this.
tell you what I'm thinking. I'm thinking we could steal some beasts from the pens at Hogwarts.
You may want to move.
Revelio.
It's a pleasant surprise. It's a...
Does not belong. Vegetables in combat. Ridiculous. You'll pay for that. You'd be better suited for gardening than for I won't rest. Dead. You won't get away.
Revelio.
Incendio.
You've made Upper Hogsfield safer, and for that, I thank you.
I could use some gold.
The good you've done on behalf of the Upper Hogsfield Red.
Madame Beaumont, I believe I have some news of your brother.
Badolf? What do you know of my brother?
I regret to say that Badolf had been turned into an Inferius, and I had to kill him.
What? But how could you possibly think that an Inferius was my brother Badolf? That's absurd.
He was wearing a woolen jumper, hand-knitted.
No. No. This can't be.
I'm truly sorry. I wish it had been better news. I wish you well, Madame Beaumont.
Oh, Badolf!
Come now, don't be stingy!
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Professor Weasley?
Somewhere away from prying eyes.
Forgive me, the headmaster stopped me and I... Merlin's beard! I see you've wasted no time. Well done. Shall we?
Off to you, Professor. What is this place?
This is the Room of Requirement. It only appears when one is in real need of it. Ordinarily, a student might stumble upon this room entirely by accident. If ever. I'd only planned to suggest to you how to find it by walking past that bit of wall, focusing on what you need. But you've managed to reveal the room on your own. While I'm here, we should take advantage of the moment. Now, where is Deke? He must have sneaked past and gone ahead.
Deke, Professor?
The house elf I was speaking to in my classroom your first day. Thought he might help you use the room once you've found it. There's no chance I'm clambering over this mess. This presents the perfect opportunity to teach you Evanesco. the vanishing spell. You can cast Evanesco to vanish certain objects, such as these chairs and other things here in the room. I suggest you practice the wand movements first, then you can clear the chairs away. Splendid. Now, cast Evanesco on those chairs. Excellent work. You'll note that you are now in possession of Moonstone. We shall discuss its uses later. Let's move on.
Revelio.
Where in Merlin's name is that elf? Is that... goodness. My old school bag. I wondered where that had got to. Can't believe it's still here. I'll just take a quick look at this. Give you an opportunity to explore on your own until we locate Deke.
Yes, Professor.
Dear.
Revelio.
Can't you keep it down? Some of us are trying to rest.
Revelio. Revelio. Thank you.
Hope this isn't as precarious as it looks.
An intruder! Stop them!
Revelio!
No, not... That's not helpful, you worthless pile of tin!
Revelio!
How does anyone other than a house elf manage to get around in here? What was that? Was that a golden snitch?
Perhaps you should summon the police and find out!
Revelio! Revelio.
I hope that house elf can find us in here.
Come to you. Hello.
Ah, Deke, we've been looking for you.
Apologies, Professor Weasley. Deke was looking through some of what's appeared in the room since Deke was last here. Is this the student?
Indeed it is.
Deke is honored to meet you.
Deke has been a friend since I was a second year. We discovered this room together. I mentioned you to Deke. We believe that you might be able to benefit from this room like I did. Deke, would you be so kind?
Of course, Professor Weasley. The Room of Requirement will always be equipped for the Seeker's needs. It's unplottable, so won't appear on any map. Most happen upon it by accident, if ever. Deke seen students in need of an extra file for potions stumble upon the room filled with them. You seem to have accessed it in its form as the Room of Hidden Things.
I was thinking about needing a place away from prying eyes. Brilliant.
Oh, that explains it then.
What I need specifically is a place where I can catch up on my schoolwork without distraction.
Well then, the room can provide you with precisely that. Now, it's time to focus on what you need. Just close your eyes. Imagine the room precisely as you need it. The room will do the rest.
Given yourself quite a canvas to work with. I look forward to seeing what you do with the space. Ah, and it seems the room has provided you with a desk of description. Excellent. It can identify unfamiliar items of clothing. One should always understand the effects of anything in which one is clothed. You'll find plenty of items of clothing that need to be identified. The desk will be an invaluable resource.
I imagine the desk of description will come in handy.
It will. I hope you'll take advantage of it. Now, I'll give you a brief lesson in conjuring. The room might not provide everything you need on its own.
Conjuring?
Yes, the magic of creating or conjuring objects. I'll teach you. Very good. When conjuring more complex objects, you'll need what's called a spellcraft. Spellcrafts are like recipes. They list the ingredients or resources needed to conjure a particular object. You should have acquired some for a potion station and potting table from tomes and scrolls in Hogsmeade.
I did. Where can I find the resources I need?
While resources such as moonstone can be obtained throughout the Highlands, it's much safer and easier to purchase them. They can also be collected by vanishing objects in the room, such as the chairs you vanished earlier. In fact, you should have enough resources for now.
I see. Can I regain resources by vanishing something I've already conjured?
You can indeed. Quite perceptive. Why don't you give it a try? Go ahead and conjure the potion station and potting table. You should find both familiar since they'll resemble the ones you've already used to study magical plants and brew potions in class.
Thank you.
Well done. You can use these whenever you need to brew potions or grow plants. Presuming, of course, you've collected any seeds or potion ingredients you need in Hogsmeade or outside the castle grounds. Deke will be here to answer any questions you may have. Do not underestimate his insights.
I will be sure to speak with Deke if I need anything. Thank you.
Good luck. I shall linger a bit longer in case you'd like to learn another transfiguration spell for use in the room. Transfiguration, if you have a moment.